Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, still in Houston area of Texas for a few more days before I head out across through Arkansas, through Little Rock, through Nashville, through Knoxville, down to, over to Asheville in North Carolina, brothers and sisters. If you're along that way, if you could message me by the grace of God, maybe we could meet, or I could stop along the way, Lord willing. If you want to have a Bible study you want to do, a prayer meeting, pray for people, end times teaching for yourself, your friends, neighbors, whatever, just contact me, brothers and sisters, anywhere along that route. It should really be anywhere between Little Rock and Asheville. Okay, brothers and sisters, I got a message that the Lord has just put on me. As a matter of fact, I had a message to make the other day. I made two videos the other night. And I had a third message, and I had been, my throat was dry. It was getting late. Anyway, so I want to start out with a different message right now as the Lord would lead me. And the Lord would give me a Bible verse. Really, the Lord had spoke to me. There's a song called Jesus Paid It All. And the Lord just kept speaking that to me and told me to listen to that song, you know, Jesus Paid It All. Now all to him I owe. And if sin had left a crimson stain, and he washed it white as snow. Jesus paid it all, and all to him. Sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. It goes on like that. But anyway, the Lord had given me a Bible verse as I was praying. Excuse me, as I was looking at this. And it's 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 23. Well, let's look at 22 also. For he that is called in the Lord, being a servant... Jesus was here talking about people who were slaves and people who were free, is the context of the words that the Apostle Paul is writing here. But let me just read this. For he that is called is in the Lord, being a servant or a slave, is the Lord's free man. You're free. Likewise, also he that is called being free is Christ's servant. And ye are bought with a price. This is the Bible verse of the Lord. Quicken to me. Ye are bought with a price. Be not ye the servants of men. Now, you know, I think I'll title this video Message for the Lord, or let's call it a rebuke from the Lord to people in the ministry. Because I know lots of you who are watching this right now, lots of people are very busybody, very nosy. You know, I've made some excellent, I mean really, some excellent theological teaching about the end times and all that. And I will title it something, I don't know, I can't think of it. I'll give it some mundane sounding title. And maybe 300 or 400 people watch it. And it's an excellent teaching. Then I made one where I had told the brothers and sisters, actually the sisters who I talked to, but they're married, in Atlanta that I would come for a week, and then I ended up changing my schedule because I had an opportunity to preach in North Carolina, and the Lord had actually led me before they contacted me about preaching that, no, you know, don't go down there now at this time. So I'd changed the schedule, and then I was supposed to go again, and I had a little trouble finding the place, and so I made a video apologizing. I put apology to the brethren in Atlanta. Now about 700 people watched that video. And it was nothing to do with the Bible, no teaching, no end times, no anything. But yet people are so nosy and so busybody to see something like that. So when I made a video like a rebuke for those who are left behind, and tons of people watch it because they want to see some rebuke. They want to see some WWF. They want to see some, you know, fake like wrestling and all this kind of stuff like politics. You know, people arguing on these talk shows and stuff, the talking heads on Crossfire on CNN or Fox News or whatever. They like to see some confrontation. And this is definitely a spirit of the flesh. So this video is not about the flesh, but about the Spirit of God. And Jesus has paid it all for us. If I titled this video, Jesus Paid It All, which people would say, oh, that's the gospel, we don't need to watch that. No, you need, that's what you need to hear, that Jesus paid it all. But in this context, I got two things to talk about in the same topic. One is for people who are in the ministry. Now, the problem with the American church, with the pastors, is they're not looking to Jesus to have paid it all, and that includes their finances and everything they need. Now, when you talk about the word salvation, okay, included in the word salvation is deliverance, healing. Go look it up. When you talk about the word salvation in Greek or in Hebrew, we're talking about deliverance, like the children of Israel were saved out of bondage. You know, they were delivered. They were healed. It says in this one of the Psalms that, you know, their clothes didn't wear out and they didn't get sick and all this stuff. So just as an example, in the word salvation, there's physical healing. There's spiritual healing. There's deliverance. There's provision. Finances being one of them. And that's what I'm using this because, you know, I'm not a prosperity gospel guy, but God does. If we give, Jesus said, we will be given to us in good measure, shaken up and pressed down and running over one man given to our bosom. With the same measure you measure, it'll be measured back to you. That's how God operates. When you sow, whatever you sow, that's what you reap. The Bible says you reap what you sow. If you reap to the flesh, you reap a whirlwind. You reap corruption. If you sow to the Spirit, you know, you reap blessings. You reap rewards in this earth and in heaven. So money is just one of those things. But on TV, that's all they talk about. I watch these fundraisers they're doing on Christian television. It's all about money. I even saw them they had a money machine, like snow machine, you know, blowing dollar bills floating all through the air. Knowing then they're probably using $100 bills. I didn't look at it that closely. You know, and it's money has become their God. As the Bible says, the love of money is the root of all evil. Now, that being said, we're not talking about that. Money is a big issue. It's an important part of our lives. It takes money to do the work of God. It takes money to buy food, to feed your family. Money is a medium of exchange. Now, how do we get money? Time. Just as, not to change topics, but time. Money is the fruit of our time that we spend. Like you go to a job, you give a company your time, they give you money for that. You know, you're a lawyer. Lawyers bill by the hour. Doctors get paid, you know, per visit. But it's the time you spend. You know, you get paid for that. Your compensation. And money is the instrument, the currency is an instrument that represents our time spent working or what. Okay, so the problem in the ministry for ministers is that they forgot that Jesus paid it all. And as it says right here, ye are bought with a price. Who bought us? Jesus Christ. Be not ye the servants of men. So the problem with pastors, lots of them, this is what's wrong with the American church. And in the Philippines, too. 90% of all the pastors I've ever worked with, they're servants of men. They've been bought with the price of a dollar or whatever it is, how many dollars it is, whether it's big money. The Lord had led me. I didn't even want to see this mess. The Lord had led me. I was looking at the TV. I'd watch this fundraising stuff where they're blowing the money. And then the Lord led me to look at this Preachers of L.A. I didn't even want to watch it. I've seen several of those guys on TBN and stuff, like that McClendon guy. With his entourage and living like millionaires and all this kind of stuff. And living large. People pleasers. People pleasers. Now, I understand. Look, I've done all that stuff as far as evangelism and all that. And trying to get people to come. And then they were talking about, they had some rap concert and inviting people. See, your religious people will say, oh, rap is not from God. Well, you can rap a Christian song. You can sing it with country music. You can sing it a cappella. You can sing it with rock music, whatever. I'm not talking about that, you old Pharisees. I'm talking about one of the preachers said, he went and met these gang members. And it's noble that he's trying to win the gang members to the Lord. It's supposed to be to the Lord. But he said, I want to show them that a Christian concert can be just as fun as going to see, you know, he named some, you know, whatever, Dr. Dre or whoever these rappers are. Now, the problem is we don't need to show anybody, you know, that Jesus can be like the world. That's not what we're called to do. We are not called to win a popularity contest. You know, we're not here to win friends and build our own kingdom. And that's, you know, brothers and sisters, lots of you guys watch me on YouTube. And, you know, you like me and all that stuff. And when I meet people, lots of the people that I meet. See, that's where, you know, it's, I'm not a people pleaser. Never did. By the grace of God, may I never sell my soul, you know. As they say, everyone has a price. You know, by the grace of God, may I have no price. But there are people who sell their soul for a low price. You know, that's the joke I was, you know, thinking about today. At least those preachers from LA are selling their soul for a big mansion and all that, and living ultra extravagant, driving Bentley cars and Mercedes and all this jewelry. They got an entourage, private jets, all that kind of stuff, like Benny Hinn. You know, I've seen preachers that sold their soul for much less than that. So at least they're going for it, you know, or like David Koresh, the Branch Davidians there. Of course, it wasn't money, but he sold his soul to, he was sleeping with all the women, and he had like 100 different kids. And, you know, like this, whatever, this other Mormon leader that they put in jail recently out there in Utah. I mean, they sold their soul for a high price. And most of the people I see, they sell their soul for a much lower price. So if you want to sell your soul and deny the Lord that bought you, at least go for it, you know. Go for the gusto. You know, it's like, don't rob a bank for a few thousand dollars. I saw something too, because I don't usually watch TV. I was watching all this on the same time, and I didn't know the Lord was leading me to watch all this, and I didn't know why. Now, it's just now, as I'm speaking, I see how it's even all connected. I watched this thing about the pizza bomber. Remember that? They put this bomb around this guy's neck. Maybe it was 10 or 15 years ago, before I went to the Philippines. And the bomb blew up on his neck and killed him. He was supposed to be a pizza delivery guy and went to rob a bank. And anyway, in the story, they were saying that the woman who masterminded all this, she had an inheritance of $1.8 million. And she had to spend $250,000 to kill her dad so she could get this money. Now, her dad was already in his 70s or 80s or whatever. And she's an old, evil, demon-possessed looking woman, drug addict, and she needed $250,000 to kill her dad so she could get her $1.8 million. So they plotted this thing for the guy with the pizza bomber guy to go in there and rob the bank, and then she could pay for her dad to be killed, then they could split the money, $1.8 million. Well, the thing is when he left the bank, the guy had $8,000. And anybody with any sense would know that when you go into a bank, the tellers only have so much money in their drawer. You know, they don't have $1 million or $250,000 just out in the bank. Each teller has a few thousand or whatever. So if you robbed all the tellers down the line, maybe you're going to get, in this case, $8,000 of a mere penance to be killed, to have your head blown off like that guy did, or, you know, the rest of them to go to jail for the rest of their lives. For such a small amount, they sold their souls. And that's what I see in the church. The preachers have sold their souls for a small amount, when Jesus already paid it all for you. The Bible says, in him we live and breathe and have our being. You know, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You know, my God shall provide all of your needs according to his riches in glory. Now, when you read that too, I just want to throw this out there. In Philippians, I believe it's 4:19, Paul is saying those people who had tithed and like they were worried about, you know, their finances, and he's saying that, my God shall provide all your needs according to his riches in glory. Why? Because those people have been giving. Giving, it'll be given unto you. So that's God's system, that we give and it's given unto you. I give my time, like myself, I give my time to doing the orphanage. You know, and God blesses me and he blesses us in different ways. You know, blessing is not always money, it's peace. God blesses us with healthy family. God blesses us with, you know, opportunities to meet people who we'd like to meet, whatever. God can bless us in any kind of way, in peace, in love, in joy, whatever, the fruit of the Spirit, the gifts of the Spirit. God can bless us with the gift of interpreting tongues. God can bless us with the gift of healing because we gave our time to, you know, go pray with 100 people who were sick, and then God blesses us. You know, we sowed our time in praying for people that were sick in the hospital, and then God honored us by giving us a gift of healing as an example, not always necessarily monetary. Okay, so ye are bought with a price, but be not ye the servants of men. Now, church members, the biggest problem, I'm talking about the American church. Why is the American church dying? Why is America going to hell? The church is not fulfilling its role. Church members, you've been bought with a price by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. God will provide all of our needs according to his riches in Christ Jesus. And yet, we're afraid to tell people the gospel. You know, we're people pleasers, because we looked at people, well, you know, in this case, it's not necessarily money, it's that friendship. You know, Jesus paid for us. Jesus said, don't think that I come to bring peace, but a sword, that the father will be the enemy of the son-in-law, and the son-in-law the enemy of the father-in-law, mother-in-law, and all that, brother against sister. Your enemies will be of your own household. But people are, they're, you know, they are not willing to worry about, you know, they're not willing to give up a friendship in order to, you know, to do the will of God. Jesus already paid for all of that. Jesus is the one who provides us with our family. You know, I have many relatives who are not Christians, like most all of you. God provides me with family and friends. God provides me with fulfillment in my life through various ways and various people. Not as I would deem it or as the world deems it, but as He wills it. There's another verse I was just going to look at. That's 1 Corinthians chapter 3. It's just slipping my mind as I'm talking about that. Brothers and sisters, Jesus has paid it all, and all to Him we owe. We owe to no man or woman nothing. I'm not going to let anybody buy me, own me, control me. No man, no woman. I've been through all of that in my 13 years of the ministry. And by the grace of God, may I never be bought. But I'm only a man, just like any of you are only man, only a woman. The Bible says God will not allow us to be tempted about what we can handle. And He will always make a way of escape. My friends, brothers and sisters, and preachers who are listening to this, if any preachers would not be so arrogant not to watch a YouTube video, which most of them, that's the problem too. They're so arrogant they can't receive anything from anybody else. I'll say this to you. If you are the pastor of a church that compromises the gospel, which 90% of them are doing today in these last days, in the last 10, 20 years, God will make a way of escape for you. Either A, you get up there and preach the truth, and then they're going to throw stones at you and cast you out, fire you, whatever they got going to do. God's got a plan for you. God's got a way for you. Do not compromise with the world. Do not compromise. Jesus already paid. No people can pay you enough to replace the blood of Jesus. There is no amount of money, no amount of benefits, no amount of prestige, no amount of nice houses and clothes and cars and all that. None of those things can ever be worth the cost of the blood of Jesus. Jesus already paid it all. He paid it all for you and me. I got more videos to make, brothers and sisters. Like I said, I hope that those old busybodies, nosy Pharisees who's trolling on the, looking for some controversy and something to, you know, like a, oh, Pastor Patrick said this about so-and-so, I'm going to run and go message so-and-so. Oh, Pastor Patrick's talking about you or whatever they think. I hope those busybodies will repent. I hope if you are a nosy busybody looking for, you know, some controversy and excitement of people debating and arguing on YouTube, shame on you. Shame on you. The Bible says the things that God hates, one of them is those feet that are swift to make mischief and cause discord among the brethren. Those, you know, the Bible talks about the people call it the deadly sins, the things that God hates, an abomination to God, a proud look, all these different ones. And one of them is a feet that are quick to spread mischief and causing discord among the brethren. Shame on you. Jesus paid all in full, all our provision. That's our salvation, our healing, our finances, our favor, you know, jobs, whatever it is, God, the Lord Jesus Christ already paid it all for us. And to Him, I owe everything. Jesus is the one who provides everything for me. He is my provider, Jehovah Jireh. And I will never, by the grace of God, I keep adding that in there. You know, we can't be boastful in what we say. That's the difference. If you listen to what I'm saying, we can't be boastful in what we say. By the grace of God, by His blood, by His grace, by His help, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And by the grace of God, I will never, never sell out. Never sell out. Lord, help me that I would never, never sell my soul for no amount of money, no amount of prestige or people-pleasing attitude that these preachers have done. And brothers and sisters, there's nothing to whine about. I came to the States to do God's will and lift my voice and speak out. And I care not, in by the grace of God, that my eyes are not on the fact that the word of God, the pure gospel, is not received. I know that. I already knew that when I came here. I'm not disappointed. I don't care. It doesn't matter. I'm only worried, am I, Patrick Winfrey, doing the will of God? Jesus bought me. He paid for me. I am His bondservant. And may I always speak His word, His way, in His time, in His will. And by God and by His grace, may His will be done. And may no man, no man, And no weapon, no woman formed, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against me, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. Isaiah 55:17. It's in him I trust. In him I count. In him I rest. In him I breathe and move and have my being. The Lord Jesus Christ is the way, my truth and my life, my Redeemer, my Savior, my risen Savior, my exalted Lord and my Christ, my Lord and my God, my King of kings and the Lord of lords. He is my salvation. He's my deliverer. He's my provider. He's my Jehovah Jireh. He is my healer. He is my King. He is my Lord. He is our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus has paid it all for you and me. All to him we owe. I encourage you to bow the knee right now and say, Lord Jesus Christ, forgive me. Lord Jesus Christ, forgive me for worrying about what people think about the gospel and how people might be offended by you, Lord. Lord Jesus, you said no servant is above his master. They hated me. Know that they will hate you also, you said, Lord Jesus. You said it's only good enough for a servant to be like his master. Lord, may we be like you, Lord. Lord, may we count it as the Apostle Paul said, may we count it all as lost for the sake of knowing you. May we count it all as dung. Everything in this world is dung, manure of animals that's good for a burning, for this, that we count it all as dung, Lord, in this world for the sake of knowing you. In Jesus' name, count it all as lost. Anything in this world, I'm not of this world. The cares of this world, I cast my cares upon the Lord, for he cares for me, the Bible says. The things of this world grow strangely dim in the light of his loving embrace. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. The world behind me. Hallelujah. No turning back. 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 I release it right now as the Lord is releasing that anointing right now of revival, of holiness. No turning back in Jesus' name. No turning back. The world is behind me now. And I pray that the world is behind you now as you turn your eyes upon Jesus. The things of this world grow strangely dim in the light of his loving embrace. Love lifted me, as the song. Another, I keep quoting all these Bible verses and songs. Everything I said was from Bible verses and song, Christian songs. Love lifted me when nothing else would do. Nothing else could save me. His love lifted me. His love lifted me when nothing else would do. His love lifted me. May the Lord Jesus Christ lift you right now out of the situation you're in. Physical healing. In sin, sin in bondage, alcohol, cursing, you know, foul language, language unbecoming of a Christian, motives, actions unbecoming of a Christian, behavior unbecoming of a Christian. As the Bible says, you know, we're supposed to avoid all appearance of evil. Be set free right now in Jesus' name, because Jesus already paid for it. He already paid for you to speak in tongues, be baptized in the Holy Spirit. He already paid for you to be physically healed. He already paid for you to be born again. He already paid for you to enter the kingdom of heaven. He already paid for you to have everything you need in this life. As Jesus said, Matthew 6:33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. The kingdom of God and his righteousness. Jesus Christ. And all those earthly things you need will be added unto you. Finances, a job, whatever, clothing, friendship in this world, people as your family, companions, you know, all the things you need in your life, physical health, wisdom, intelligence, how to do your job, how to do this, how to deal with your children, how to deal with your relatives, how to deal with your parents, how to deal with strangers, or whatever, all of those things that you need in this world. God is our provider. He already paid it all for you and me. And all to him we owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, but Jesus' blood has washed it white as snow. turn to the Lord Jesus Christ right now. Repent of all you've done. All of your deeds are filthy rags in the eyes of the Lord. Mine are too. All of our deeds, the Bible says, are filthy rags in the eyes of God. We have to stand naked before Him unashamed. Stop trying to put a fig leaf over yourself like Adam and Eve did. And stand naked before the Lord. And say, Lord, here am I. Without you, I am nothing. Without His righteousness, I am nothing. Without His work, Jesus already did all the work for you. Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. Lord, we just honor you right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. I thank you, Lord, for the blood. I thank you for your blood, Lord Jesus, that cleanses us of all unrighteousness. Lord, I thank you for your provisions that you've made for us. All things have been provided for us in Christ Jesus, Lord. Father, we thank you. We thank you for the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you for his work on the cross. We thank you for by his stripes we are healed. We thank you that by his blood our sins are washed away, removed, to be remembered no more, you said, Lord. And Father, we honor you. We praise you, Lord. Lord, let us free from being captive to the will of man, that thy will be done in us as it is in heaven. In Jesus' name, be set free from the will of man. Be not a people pleaser, and don't let people try to control you, manipulate you, put you in bondage. Like a cat playing with a mouse, you know, like the Lord had showed me. Sometimes people is like a cat playing with a ball, you know, like a ball of yarn. They're just playing with you, toying with you, controlling, manipulating. I'm not my own. I've been bought with a price. You, if you're a Christian, you're not your own. You've been bought with a price. Be no man's servant. No church, no congregation, no relatives, no parents. If you're an adult, you are not the servant of even your parents or your friends or your cousins or your children and all those things. We are bond servants of the Lord Jesus Christ, here to do his will, be salt and light, and do his will in this earth as it is in heaven. To bring his name glory, not our own, not to get our own vain glory, but his name be glorified in us as it is in heaven. That's a whole other thing, a whole other angle looking at it. Now, all these preachers are not just wimpy and Ahabs under the power of Jezebel. Lots of Jezebels out there in churches trying to make the pastors a little wimpy, little Ahab. Read the story about Jezebel and Ahab. You know, there's a huge Jezebel spirit in the States. I didn't even get into all that. People get caught up in all that. Right now, it don't even matter what you want to call it. This is the fruit of it, what I'm talking about, fruit of Jezebel's spirit. Don't even worry about that. Worry about being free in Christ. But the whole other side is lots of people, it's Ahab, is also playing like he's weak and wimpy. But in reality, their motive is to promote their own kingdom, not that they're afraid of people. But they want to be on the throne. They want to be like the Most High God, like Satan did, you know. You can read about it and say, I will ascend on the Most High. I will be like the Most High. I will sit on the mountain of God. You know, that rebellious attitude, I will, I will, I will. There's lots of preachers and people who are also in that position. I guess those are the ones who are doing the manipulating, not on the weak ones on the end of that have been manipulated. The other end of what we're talking about. The people pleasers and those who demand to be pleased. You're not in charge of anybody. Jesus Christ is in charge. God is in charge. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. And he will exalt you in due time. The Bible says, Jesus said, those who exalt themselves will be humbled. And those who humble themselves will be exalted. And if you humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, the Bible says, he will exalt you in due season, in due time. He will be the one to exalt you as a pastor or a leader or whatever in his kingdom that he would call you to do. He's the one, his timing, not our timing. Not in our kingdom, but his kingdom. God bless you guys. I can go on and on and on about this. I'm just waiting on the Lord as the Spirit of the Lord would flow. God bless you guys. I ask you to continue to pray for the orphanage as we are making our plan to protect the orphans and the orphanage and all that and all the equipment that we have, the stuff for the feeding. You know, people try to steal the motorcycle to take the orphans to school. People trying to steal the pots and, you know, the big pots we use for the feedings and all that kind of stuff. Pray that these people will be arrested, that they later on they'll get saved, all of that. Then also pray that we will have, you know, that we can, we need to have security. whatever we need, because this is a physical threat to the house, mom and dad, and also to the orphans. They would be able to defend themselves. God bless you guys. See you up there.